Hello guys, welcome to another tutorial. In this tutorial, we are going to be creating this contact info page here. As you can see, you got your email there, you got your number, and then you got your location there with these icons on top here. So this is also responsive. So if you are viewing it on the smaller, you see it's responsive there. As you can see, it's looking like that. So this is what we are going to be creating there. So yeah, I'm excited, but before we get started, I just want to ask you that if this is your first time here, then please consider subscribing and hit the notification bell so you get notified every time we upload a new tutorial. So yeah, with that being said, let's get started. So to get started, I already have my HTML file open up here, and I also have my CSS, which I link to my HTML, and I'm running a live server, so my file is open up in my browser here. As you can see, it's empty at the moment. So I just want to come to my HTML and start writing my code. So the first thing I want to create is create a div with the class name of container. So I'm just going to write container there and then press tab, and that will create a div with the class name of container. And then I want to, inside this class container, I want to create another div with this. I just want to give it a class name of info. Right, press tab. So inside this info div, I want to add a couple of things. So the first thing I want to do is just add a link, and then this link I want to give it a class name of contact, right? Create that, and then this link is going to be linking nowhere. So inside this link, I want to add my icons. So the icons that I'm going to be using, I want to use this font awesome icons here. So just come down here, and then I want to copy this. So if you don't know how to use font awesome icons, I did a video about this, so I will leave the link in the description. So just want to copy this, right? And then I want to come into my HTML file and then paste it down there. So as you can see, I paste it down inside my link tag here. This is the opening and closing tag. So just want to close off this and then it remain with my file here. So now if you come in here and save, you will see in the corner here you got this envelope icons there. So just want to come down here and then add a couple of things. No, come down, I mean still inside my info, my info div there. So inside here I want to create another div, and then this div I will just want to give it a class name of content. So content, right? And then this I just want to add a p tag. And then I just want to add my email. Let's say just lorem, and then let's say lorem@mail.com, right? See that, and then you save. So if you save and then come in here, you see you got this here up here, right? So now instead of rewriting this whole thing, I just want to come here and then copy this info div here. I want to copy this, copy that, and then I want to paste it 2 times. So I'm pasting it inside my container div there, right? So come down, paste it 1 time, and then come down again, paste it 2 times, right? So if you save, you come in here, you got it this, you got it right this. So let's just change a couple of things. And now I want to, this is your email, so I want to come here and then change this. Let me just enlarge this so that you can see. Enlarge this. So I want to come here and then change this envelope. I want to change it to phone, since I want to keep this a phone. And then I want to change the p tag, since this is going to be a number. So let's just say 555555. And then I want to come down, change this an envelope, change it to, I want this to be my location, so I want to map and then marker, right? And then I want to come to the p tag and then save. Let's just say building office, just say building office, and then let's say downtown, right? Save that. See, you come down here, you got this. You got your mail there, your phone, and then your location. So yeah, come down here. This is what we have so far in our HTML. And now that's all I want to do in my HTML. So let's jump right straight into our CSS. So in here, let me just enlarge this a bit so that you can see like that. right? So in my CSS, the first thing I want to do is just reset everything to zero. So set the margin, I want to set it to zero, and then the padding, I want to set it to zero as well, right? And then save that. You see, you remove all the margin and padding there. So the next thing I want to target now is this div here with a class name of container here. So let's just call that, and then I will know it's container, right? So with this, I just want to set the position. I want to set it to relative, and then I want to use the font family. I want to use sans serif, which is a built-in font. And then the next thing I want to do here is just give it a minimum height. Let's just give it to 100 view h. So, and then the next thing I want to do is just display everything and to display it flex. And then the next thing I want to do here is just justify content to the center. And then I want to align item to the center as well. And then the next thing I want to do is just flex wrap. I want to wrap them, right? And then the last thing I want to do is just set the background. The background, I want to set it to light gray. I want to use light gray, right? Save that. And then if you come in here, you got it right that. If you see here, you got it right that. So let's fix that. Now let's move on to targeting this div with a class name of info. So I want to come down there, and then you know is info, is the class name of info, right? So the first thing you want to do is just target the position. You want to set it to relative, and then you want to display everything, display it flex as well. And then you want to justify content. You want to center them, right? And then you want to align items to the center as well. And then the next thing you want to do is just set the height of this. Let's set it to 150 pixel. And then let's just set the width of this. Let's set it to 280 pixel. And then the next thing I want to do is just change the background. Let's use this blackish here, right? And then if you save that, see, you got it right there, right? Perfect. So now the next thing I want to do is just add some padding to this. Let's say to 20 pixel, and then let's add some margin. I just want to add them to, let's say, to 20 pixel as well. You save that, you got it like that. Now I just want to flex wrap. I want to wrap it. And then the last thing I want to add here is just add a flex direction. So flex direction, I want to set it to column. So save that. See, you got it right there, right? Perfect. Now let's target these icons here. So I want to come out here. We know these icons got a class name of contact, right? This class name of contact there. So let's call that, come out here. And then I just want to come down here, call it, we know it's inside your info, but then this is a contact, right? That's what you are targeting. So the first thing you want to do here is just set the position. You want to set it to relative, and then if you change the color, we want to change the color there. So color, I want to use this whitish, right? If you save that, you see, you got it right there. So now next thing I want to do is just set the font size. Let me just enlarge this a bit, low, set it to 20 pixel. And then if you save, you got it right there. And then the next thing I want to do is just change the background. I want to set the background. I want to use this color here, which is 1ABC9C. So if you save that, you see, you got this background color there. So let's just fix that since it's messy. So come down here. Next thing I want to do is just add some padding to that. So this is padding, let's just make it 10 pixel. And then I want to set the height. The height of this, let's just set it to 30 pixel, and then I want to set the width. The width I want to set it to 30 pixel as well. So if you save that, you got it like that. So far so good. So let's move on. Now I want to make this a circle, so I want to set the border radius. I want to make it 50%. So if you save that, you see you got there in circle. But if you look close, you'll see this, your icons here, is on the edge there. It's on the edge. So but then you wanted it to be in the middle, so let's fix that. To do that, just want to display, want to display it flex, right? And then I want to come down here, I want to justify contact there to the center, and then I want to align item, want to center it as well, right? And then if you save this, you see you got it in the middle there. It's now in the middle, but if you look, you see it's underlined since it's our link, so we have to remove that. So come in here and then text decoration there, you have to set it to none, right? Save that, and then you see it's now looking perfect. Good. So now we are done with that. So let's move on to our text here. So we know, if you come in here into our HTML file, if you come in here, you know your text here is inside this div with the class name of contact, right? Perfect. So let's come down here and then call it. If you come down there, you know it's inside your info, and then this time you are targeting your content, right? So the first thing you want to do is just set the position. You want to set it to relative, and then you want to set the width, let's just set it to 100%. And then the next thing I want to do is just text other line, I want to center it, right? And then I just want to give it some margin, let's just say 20 pixel to the top and bottom, and then 0 pixel to the left and right. And then if you save that, you see you got it down a bit there. So let's move on. Now I want to come down here, and then I just want to set the font size, let's set it to 15 pixel, and then I want to bold them. So font weight, I want to, let's set it to 700. And then the next thing I want to do is just set the color, I want to set it to whitish, right? And then next thing I want to do is just add a cursor. That's the last thing I want to add, and set it to a pointer. So save that. Now you see you got it right there, got your text there. So now we want to set it, once you hover on them, you want them to be underlined. So you just come down, you know it's contact there. So now you want, once you hover it, right, so you want to text decoration, you want to underline it. So save that. So now you see, once you hover on this, it's being underlined, right? You got it right there. Perfect. And then now, since this is responsive, so if you are viewing it on the bigger screen, you'll see it's looking like that, and then it's looking like that, right? Perfect. Got it right there. So perfect. And that brings us to the end of this tutorial. I hope you find this video helpful. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you happen to have a question, then drop it in the comments down below. And if this was your first time, then please consider subscribing and hit that notification bell so you get notified every time we upload a new tutorial. So with that being said, I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm out. Peace, love, and unity.